thank you for making time with me to talk about your new children's book and book series. You've been everywhere. It's funny, this morning I was in the Starbucks and I was just sort of, you know, looking up and it's like, you're here, you're here, you're here, you're here. Toronto loves you. They love what you've done in Hollywood and they love the fact that you have something very special for us. First, I have to ask you, your success in Hollywood, Academy Award nominee, representing Canada, how does it feel knowing that you're, in your way, helping open or keep that door open for other Canadians to have success?
Oh, I mean, I love that. That is definitely, it's funny, I've thought of it that way for women in Canada, but I've never thought of it for all Canadians. That's even better. So thank you. Yeah, no, it's, I mean, Canadians are so talented. And so I particularly like our sense of humor.
Yeah.
I think our sense of humor that we can bring into serious topics is kind of unique. And the world needs that. So, yeah.
I like how you said that because it really transcends into what we're going to talk about with your book series, because it's kind of the same thing, because even though there's humor and there's, you know, great stories, there's also a serious side to this. So what is the series about and why do we have such unusual animals as our main characters?
Series is about endangered and misunderstood animals. So it came from the realization that there's all these animals that are endangered that I've never heard of. And perhaps because they're considered ugly or bad luck in the case of the eye, or so I wanted to give them a voice, and I wanted children to fall in love with them for their own unique characteristics, and I also wanted to raise money for the conservation of the animals that aren't at the table really right now. So all the money from the books goes towards conservation of each animal of each book.
Now, you know, we talked about your Hollywood success, but from what I've heard, you actually have always wanted to write children's books. Why was this the right time to do it?
It's true. And it's honestly, every New Year's comes up and it's a thing I beat myself up for. Why haven't you written a children's book? It's always been the dream. And people are always like, well, isn't writing movies harder? Why did that come before your actual dream? Not to diminish I feel so grateful for the movies that I've been able to do. But it honestly, I just never had the right idea. And then suddenly it all came together and it combined. I've also wanted to have a charity that I started. And so it's just all these things came together with the idea of the series, Endangered and Misunderstood. It's like, I love animals. I love giving back. And I love children's books. So it was the right time. So I'm not beating myself up this New Year's.
Growing up, though, what was your favorite children's books?
Oh, I loved so many of them. I still have all my old. I had all the old golden books. My parents, every payday, they would buy me a new golden book. So I have my big stack of old golden books, and I have all my fairy tale books, everything.
So when you decide to write a book, and especially for something like this that's so important to you, I mean, what are your thoughts knowing what other authors have done and connecting with children? Was that difficult in sort of your own formula in being able to tell these stories and connecting with children, and hopefully it's going to be something where they pass on to their generations also?
I mean, first and foremost, I wrote it for myself. So I did the first draft to entertain myself, which is, I think, how you should always approach writing. And then I had to soften some of the things. There's a little bit of R-rated in there. It's like, okay, get that out. They don't need to know what really happens to the lemur in real life.
Yeah, exactly. Can you, for folks who watch this, in real life, what really happens?
In real life, the lemur's only in Madagascar, and he comes out at night. He's nocturnal, and he goes into the villages and he steals their food, and he's very scary looking. So there is a belief that if you see an eye, he points his finger at you especially, it means there's going to be death in the village. So the only way to not have death in the village is to kill the eye. So they kill him and they hang him up outside the village. It's really, really not good, and it's not helping him with surviving.
Oh, yeah, of course, that's definitely something you don't want in the storybooks, though. But as we talked about, though, this is a series. How is that working?
So the first one's about the eye, the endangered. I'm doing three books in each continent. So I'm on Africa now. So the first, because they've got the craziest animals, the first book's the eye, the second one's the pangolin, and the third one's the okapi.
Is there a chance, because you know everything about films, could this be an animated series? Could this go to... Oh, I'm seeing a smile here.
it's an obvious thought in the head, and yes, there has been... There has been discussions about that, yes.
Okay, crossing fingers we're going to get a chance to see this. You actually had a chance to read your book to some children here.
I did. I did one in Vancouver on Sunday, and this afternoon I'm going to a community center to read to other children. Honestly, it was probably one of the highlights of my life, no joke. It's like to actually sit there and read to the kids and to have them just pay attention and hang on every word, and then they lined up to get their names put in the books. And then the parents sent me pictures afterwards of the kids in the back seat still reading the book and the kids at home reading it. And so the response to the actual intended audience means the world.
One of them, and this was from another interview, I'm going to thank my colleague for putting that up there too. One of the kids asked you about the head of a, you know where I'm going.
Yeah, I do. So at the end, I was like, okay, there's going to be time for questions. Mm-hmm. And all these hands go up and there's a cute little girl right in the front. And I'm like, what's your question? And she goes, does a butterfly have a round head? And I was like, oh, did you see a butterfly in the story? Because the illustrator's so amazing. He hides things all over. Uh-huh. And she's like, no. I'm like, oh, well, I'll put a butterfly in the next story. And then I was flipping through I only have a few images for the next story. There's a butterfly. And so as I said to her, for you, there'll be a butterfly. Oh, and there is. I'm so glad. And yes, he does kind of have a round head and a stick. She wanted to know if he had a round head and a stick. And I think it was because I mentioned to them that in the back of the book is how to draw an eye. So I think she was thinking about what she knew how to draw.
Oh, you know what? Eyes through children. I wish that's the way the world would be, you know? Oh, so beautiful. Great Christmas gift to give children and family. So how do we get this?
Well, in Toronto, it's in Indigo. Mm-hmm. And it's on Amazon. And anywhere, do an online search, wherever your preferred shopping places, it's available online. But Indigo's carrying it in Toronto. And also the other bookstores have access to it. So if you go in and they don't have it, ask them for it. And that's a great way to help II. And all proceeds, 100% proceeds, go to II Conservation.
Since we are talking about Christmas, though, too, with the holiday season coming up, what was your favorite holiday Christmas moment growing up?
Oh, you know, it was probably Christmas Eve. Christmas Eve, I was always allowed to open one present. My mom would always strategically make sure that it was either a book or a teddy bear. And so that I would have it as the bedtime story or I would have it to sleep with. And I've always, to me, I've kept that going with my daughter and my family. It's always one. So Christmas Eve was, yeah, for sure mine.
Love it. So we know what's going on with you with 2020 in case more movies you're going to be part of or anything else. Social media is the place to go. Where do we go to follow you?
Yes, at Terri Tatchell, TerriTatchell.
Congratulations. All the best in 2020 and looking forward to this series going to some type of screen, big or small. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I really appreciate it.